It's not very often that you can find an elite pass rusher in the third round of the NFL draft, but it turns out that's exactly what the Raiders did in 2019 when they drafted Maxx Crosby. Crosby, in 3 years in the league, has already been named an All-Pro, Pro Bowler, has at least 7 sacks in every season, and has 25 sacks over the span. Plus, he's been an inspiration to many, checking into rehab for alcoholism, and has now been sober for over 2 years. Back at Eastern Michigan, he was first team All-Mac twice and was an absolute stud. But what about the defensive ends drafted before him? Like always, teams put an insane premium on quarterbacks. And because of that, sometimes the expected best player in the draft doesn't go number one. And that's exactly what happened in 2019. Everyone knew who the best overall prospect was at the draft: Nick Bosa. Bosa comes from a family of NFL players. His dad, John, was a first rounder back in 1987, and his brother, Joey, went third overall in 2016 and has been a standout for the Chargers ever since. Like Joey, Nick Bosa tore it up at Ohio State. He played in every game as a true freshman, and although he didn't start, he still had 5 sacks. Bosa was the starting defensive end for 7 games in 2017, and he was a monster. He had 8.5 sacks and was named a first team All-American. His junior year, however, was an odd one. Bosa played in only 3 games, recording 4 sacks before he had to undergo core muscle surgery. He missed the rest of the season and even withdrew from Ohio State to enter the draft. Bosa ended up going 2nd overall to the 49ers, and as a rookie, he was damn good. He was the Defensive Rookie of the Year, the NFC Defensive Player of the Month in October, made the Pro Bowl, and most importantly, helped San Francisco make the Super Bowl, where he had a strip sack. Bosa recorded 9 sacks and an interception on the season. His 2020 season was an unfortunate one, though. In Week 2, he suffered a torn ACL. He returned healthy for 2021 and had 15.5 sacks and led the league with 21 tackles for a loss. Simply put, the dude's a stud, unlike the guy taken after him. If you were waiting for the first bust on this list, look no further than the number 4 pick of the draft, Clelin Ferrell. For one, Ferrell was born and raised in Richmond, Virginia, just like yours truly. Unfortunately though, I wasn't a freak edge rusher with an offer from Clemson. Ferrell had to redshirt his first season with the Tigers due to a hand injury, but stood out the next season with 6 sacks, playing a role on a Clemson team that won the national championship. He had 9.5 sacks as a sophomore and was named a first team All-American, an honor he'd earn again in 2018. Clemson won the national championship again, and Ferrell was named ACC Defensive Player of the Year after 11.5 sacks. He was expected to be a late first round pick, but instead, the Raiders took him at 4. A bad decision looking back. Ferrell just hasn't come on like Las Vegas had hoped. As a rookie, he had 4.5 sacks. Well, that's his career high. In fact, he only has 3.5 in the last 2 years. In 2021, the Raiders demoted him to a backup. Safe to say, his career isn't on the right path. There are 3 guys that are the clear 3 best defensive ends in the class: Maxx Crosby, Nick Bosa, and this guy that the Panthers took at 16, Brian Burns. Burns was a consistent beast at Florida State. He played in every game in 2016 and led all freshmen with 8.5 sacks. He was poised for a fantastic college career, but he actually regressed. He had just 4.5 sacks the next season despite starting in every game for the Seminoles. Luckily, he bounced back as a junior, being named first team All-ACC after he had 10 sacks. It was enough for Carolina to take a shot on him in the first round, and he's been really impressive. His rookie year, he had 7.5 sacks while only starting in a handful of games. Burns did have a bigger role in 2020 and became a consistent starter, recording 9 sacks, the same amount he racked up last season too. Except in 2021, he was named to the Pro Bowl for his efforts. In only 3 seasons, Burns has proven he can be a solid guy off the edge. 10 picks later, the Redskins took Montez Sweat out of Mississippi State, although that's not where his collegiate career actually started. Sweat went to Michigan State, but played in 1 game and then redshirted the next season. Then he opted out to go to community college. Sweat had 5 sacks in his 1 season in JUCO before he left to go to Mississippi State. It was a big step up to the SEC, but Sweat made the most of it. In 2 years, he was first team All-SEC twice and had 22.5 sacks. His pre-draft journey was wild. He ran a combine record 4.41 40-yard dash, and his stock just skyrocketed. But then, he was diagnosed with a heart condition that led to his stock falling. Although, later it was discovered that it was a misdiagnosis. Sweat had an extremely productive rookie season with 7 sacks. Then, in 2020, improved to a record 9 sacks. His 2021 was weird though. He dealt with a broken jaw, but still played in 10 games and had 5 sacks. Sweat is coming off of a down year, but has proven that he can be an effective pass rusher. The last defensive end taken in the first round was LJ Collier, a kid out of TCU. Collier started off slow in college. He redshirted his first year, and then as a freshman, only played in a single game. Both as a sophomore and junior, Collier had 4.5 sacks. Like I said, it took a while for him to break out, but his senior year, it finally happened. Collier got to start, and he was a beast. 6 tackles and 11.5 tackles for a loss, enough to be named first team All Big 12. The Seahawks took him at 29, and it didn't really go that great in year 1. He suffered multiple injuries and ultimately had just 3 tackles in 11 games. Collier got to start at defensive end in every game in 2020 and ended up with 3 sacks. Clearly, the Seahawks weren't satisfied, and in 2021, he was named a backup. Collier didn't have a single sack, and the Seahawks just declined his 5th-year option. After 5 defensive ends went in the first round, another didn't go until the 3rd, when Zach Allen was selected by the Cardinals. Allen attended Boston College, where as a freshman, he really just played special teams. In 2016, Allen found some playtime on the field and impressed, recording 6 sacks. But it took until the following season for him to actually become a full-time starter. Funny enough, he actually had less sacks. Just 4, but added an interception and was even named ACC Defensive Lineman of the Week after he had 14 tackles in a single game. As a senior, Allen had clearly improved. He had 6.5 sacks, another pick, and was named second team All-ACC. It was enough for Arizona to take him at 65. He was actually named a starter before his rookie season, but due to a neck injury, he only appeared in 4 games. Unfortunately, he had another stint on injured reserve in 2020. Still, in 13 games, 7 starts, he had 2 sacks. Last year, Allen was finally able to stay on the field and start. He had 4 sacks, and at least for the time being, things are looking up for him. Finally, we have our first and only player that has changed teams on this list, Chase Winovich. He went to Michigan before he was drafted by the Patriots. I'm sure he's the best player that ever did that. Let's just say that he had a weird first couple of seasons in Ann Arbor. He was a linebacker as a freshman, and then Jim Harbaugh moved him to tight end as a sophomore, and then Winovich finally settled in at defensive end in 2016 and actually had 5 sacks. Before the 2017 season, he did ballet and jiu-jitsu to improve his game. I mean, he did improve as a junior. Who knows if that's because of the ballet? But shit, he had 8.5 sacks and was first team All Big 10. So, who really cares? He earned the honor again in 2018 after he had 5 sacks. Winovich accomplished a lot in college, but he did go 0-4 against Ohio State. Allen will go down as one of the best defensive ends in college football history. He went to Louisiana Tech, where he redshirted his first year. Then, in 2015, he played in 12 games and started 5, recording 6 sacks. He just exploded as a sophomore, setting the school record for sacks in a season with 14.5. Ferguson, in his own regards, had a down year in 2017 with just 7 sacks, but was still named first team All-CUSA for the first time. Then, the following season, he was the CUSA Defensive Player of the Year. He had 17.5 sacks, breaking his own record, and oh yeah, he became the all-time NCAA career sack leader with 45. The Ravens took him in the 3rd round, but unfortunately, the talent hasn't really transferred. He started 9 games as a rookie and had 2.5 sacks before in 2020, he only started 1 game and had 2 sacks. Ferguson was a reserve all last season, only playing in 10 games, and didn't have a single sack. From one Conference USA guy to another. The coolest name in the draft, Oshane Ximines, was selected in the 3rd round. Ximines went to ODU and just consistently got better year to year. He only played in 1 game his first year for the Monarchs, but then had 5 sacks. He had 8.5 in 2017, made his first team All-CUSA, and then really took off as a senior. He had 11.5 sacks, 18 tackles for a loss, had his only collegiate pick, and was first team All-CUSA again. The Giants drafted him late in the 3rd. and he's been okay, I guess. He started 2 games as a rookie and had 4.5 sacks, but he hasn't had a single one since. Ximines was supposed to start in 2020, but a shoulder injury derailed his season. In 2021, he only played in 10 games and didn't start. His career is far from over, but like many of the guys on this list, Ximines isn't nearly as good as the guy drafted after him, Maxx Crosby.